So coming to the second part of this beta-lactam antibiotics, we have cephalosporins. Cephalosporins are again having the same structure, that is the beta-lactam ring is there, but we can take them as a little bit advanced penicillins with extended spectrum activity and lesser chances of side effects. So cephalosporins, these are again the beta-lactam antibiotics. Cephalosporins were first isolated from cultures of the Cephalosporin acrimonium by Italian scientist Brodsky. His complete name is Giuseppe Brodsky. So it consists of dihydrotiazine ring fused to a beta-lactam ring containing appropriate side chain position 7. So this is the basic beta-lactam ring that we call it as a penicillin group or beta-lactam antibiotics. So cephalosporins we have done at 7 position, we have extra attachment here. This is the next group of drug, that is carbapenem Monobactam. So coming to the cephalosporins, it is difficult to remember the 5 generations of cephalosporins we have, but we need to remember at least 2 or 3 in each class for our exam purposes. So the first generation cephalosporins we have cephalexin and cefiderocil and cefazolin. Cephalexin, cefiderocil, cefazolin. So cephalexin is a orally available drug, cephalexin. So it has good activity against the staph aureus in the streptococcus. So first generation is basically acting against the gram-positive. So the second generation drugs are cefuroxime, cefaclor, and cefoxitin, that is cefamycin. So the second generation drugs, they are mainly active on the gram-negative bacteria. So here, the second generation drugs here are the cefuroxime, cefaclor, and cefoxitin. Cefuroxime again is available orally and parenterally. Cefaclor, cefoxitin, cefamycin, these are also available, but the most commonly used drug is cefuroxime. Other drugs are available in the second generation, such as cefotethan, cefamandrol. All these are also available. We'll be learning about them more. The third generation drugs are ceftriaxone, ceftotaxime, and ceftazidime. So the third generation drugs are now most commonly used cephalosporins, or you can take it as most commonly used antibiotics also. So cefotaxime and ceftriaxone are used most commonly in case of community acquired pneumonia, hospital acquired infections, and acute respiratory tract infections. In all the admission patients, we can see this injection, ceftriaxone or cefotaxime. So what is its role? Cephalosporins. Please mute yourself, students. Mute yourself. All the students, mute yourself. So we are now discussing about the third generation cephalosporins, that is ceftriaxone, ceftotaxone and ceftazidime. Ceftriaxone and ceftazidime are the intravenously given third generation cephalosporins. Ceftotaxone is the drug with this third generation group which is orally available. So you can see this taxim tablet, they are available. The fourth generation drugs, we have this cefepime, and the fifth generation ones are the ceftobiprole and ceftaroline. So the as the generation increases, the spectrum increases, they can act both on gram-negative, gram-positive and pseudomonal, that is anaerobic activity is also there. Okay. So the fifth generation ones are the reserved group of drugs, less commonly used, fourth generation and fifth generation. They are reserved group of drugs. Coming to the mechanism of action, we have this. That is, they have cell wall synthesis inhibition. That is, the contents of the cell will be expelled out once the cell wall synthesis is inhibited. And they act in synergistic with the protein synthesis inhibitors also. So we should remember all the protein synthesis inhibitors with cell wall synthesis inhibitors, they become the synergistic combination. So here, what is the mechanism of this cephalosporins? They are bactericidal action by cell wall synthesis inhibition. So inhibition of the cell wall synthesis is similar to the penicillins, that is inhibition of the three penicillin binding proteins, transpeptidase, endopeptidase and carboxypeptidase. All the three enzymes will be blocked. The peptidoglycan layer is important for the cell wall structural integrity. So the final transpeptidation step is in the synthesis of the peptidoglycan is facilitated by transpeptidase, known as penicillin binding proteins. So all the three enzymes are the proteins, that is penicillin binding proteins are inhibited. So beta-lactam antibiotics mimic the site and competitively inhibit the penicillin binding proteins and cross linkage of the peptidoglycan group. So coming to the first generation cephalosporins, cefadroxil, cefazolin and cefazolin. So good activity against the gram-positive bacteria as we discussed. So where they are used? They are used in surgical prophylaxis of cardiac and vascular surgery, insertion of orthopedic prosthesis, head and neck surgeries and gynecological surgeries. In all these cases, the first generation cephalosporins were used. Nowadays, less commonly used because of the resistance developed. So nowadays, the preferred drugs are the third generation drugs. So coming to the other uses here, we have treatment of soft tissue infections, particularly the outpatient settings, not for wide wounds as they are less active against the anaerobes, salmonella, all these things. So coming to the other second generation cephalosporins, we have this ciprofloxacin, cefoxitin, cefepime, and other ones are cefamandol and cefoxitin. So what is the function? Their function is to inhibit the gram-negative bacteria organisms. So these are cephalosporins. Extended spectrum activity against the indoor positive, that is the gram-negative bacteria, Proteus, Klebsiella, Moraxella, Catarrhalis, right? The Neisseria species. So they have activity against this Haemophilus influenza and Moraxella catarrhalis. The pharmacokinetics here is they are stable. They act against the beta-lactamases except for cefaclor, all are active against the beta-lactamases. So no need to add the additional clavulanic acid or Salbutamol, all those things. So they are excreted unchanged in the kidneys. We should be careful because in renal disease, they can cause problems. So probenacid included, their excretion through kidneys will be decreased and thereby extended spectrum activity of the second generation can be obtained by adding probenacid. So second generation cephalosporins, the common route here, they are using the intramuscular route and intravenous route. They can be used for community acquired respiratory tract infections as well as surgical prophylaxis of this colorectal cancer. Postoperative wound infections. In case of this suboxetine and cefotidine, they can be used against anaerobes in peritonitis. Cefuroxime, the most commonly used second generation cephalosporin is cefuroxime axetil. So cefuroxime is used for CAP, which stands for community acquired pneumonia, prophylaxis of colorectal surgeries, vaginal and abdominal hysterectomies, appendicitis, and it has also activated against bacterial vaginosis. So cefaclor has oral good activity. They can be used for upper respiratory tract infection and urinary tract infections, and it is also tried for soft tissue infections. So the third generation cephalosporins are cefixime, cefpodoxime, cefpinir, cefriaxone, cefaparazone, and cefotaxime. I told the cefotaxime is available orally and it is most commonly used. So cefpodoxime is the pediatric drug. Okay, so cefpodoxime most commonly used in pediatrics because it is safer in pediatric group. Cefpodoxime is used in case of urinary tract infections. Cefotaxime is tried most in case of skin infections and all. Cefixime is also right. Then coming to the parenteral one, cefotaxime and cefriaxone stands for most commonly used parenteral antibiotics. Third generation antibiotics is cefotaxime and cefriaxone. Cefixime is available orally. Cefpodoxime is available orally. So cefixime is given for skin infections. Cefpodoxime is tried for the pediatric patients as it is safer. So it has good oral bioavailability, broad spectrum activity against both gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. So the second generation is more of gram-negative. The third generation has both the spectrums, gram-positive and gram-negative. So it is drug of choice in suspected bacterial meningitis. So it is relatively good bioavailability. It can be used for penicillin-resistant pneumococci, special indications in treatment of Neisseria gonorrhea, chancroid, Lyme's disease, typhoid fever, severe Shigella, Salmonella infections, gram-negative brain abscess, all these conditions it is tried. It can be given for endocarditis caused by herpetic organisms. So the third generation continued drugs. Ceftazidime has activity against the pseudomonas, but should not be given as a monotherapy. It can be given as a combined drug. So here the third generation has broad spectrum of activity and extended spectrum compared to the second generation inhibiting gram-negative organisms. So they may be particularly useful for treating hospital-acquired infections, hospital-acquired pneumonias. So extended spectrum beta-lactamases are reducing the clinical utility of this class of antibiotics. So extended spectrum beta-lactamases means the clavulanic acid included drugs. So they are also able to penetrate the CNS and make useful reaction against this meningitis caused by pneumococci, meningococci, pneumoculus influenza, and suspected E. coli. So with the advent of the beta-lactamases, beta-lactamase inhibitors, the use of the third generation cephalosporin should have been decreased, but they are not decreased. Still, this cefotaxime, cefixime, they are the primary sellers in the market. Coming to the fourth and fifth generation drugs, as I told, these fourth and fifth generations are reserved drugs, should be used sparingly because if resistance develops to fourth generation, it is very difficult to go further. So the third generation, almost many bacteria have got this resistance, but still presently we use most of the third generation antibiotics. So fourth generation cephalosporins are extended spectrum cephalosporins, that is cefepime, cefepirone, cefepime, okay, cefepime and cefepime. So they have greater resistance to beta lactam agents than third generations. So many can cross the blood-brain barrier and are effective against meningitis. They are also used against the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So third generation, fourth generation can be used for Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So cefepime, broad spectrum activity against this activity, including the Pseudomonas, enhanced activity against the gram-negative bacilli, Enterobacter, Citrobacter, Serratia. All these cases we can use this cefepime. So where it is used, severe community acquired pneumonia, that is CAP, we can try this drug. So the fifth generation drugs, Viprol and Ceftaroline, these are the reserve group of drugs. So where we can use, these are presently known as the fifth generation drug. So they have powerful anti-pseudomonal characteristics and appear to be less susceptible to the development of resistance. So Ceftaroline is an injectable cephalosporin and has activity against mRNA and continuing resistance streptococcus. So it is inactive against the non-fermenters and carbapenemases. So where we can use this fifth generation? With the except of cefepime, they should not be used for treatment of Enterobacter, Serratia, Citrobacter infections due to induction of chromosomal EMPC beta lactamases in their bacteria. So they should be used sparingly. So it is not effective against Enterobacter. So there can be short answer for you, like 2 marker or 3 marker. What are the drugs which are active against Pseudomonas? So the drugs which are active against Pseudomonas are anti-pseudomonal activity cephalosporins are cefaparazole, ceftazidine, cefpirone, cefepime, cefazopran, ceftaroline, and ceftabiprole. So these are the drugs which are active against the Pseudomonas. So cephalosporins mechanism of resistance is antibiotic destruction by beta lactamases, alteration in the penicillin binding target resulting in reduced binding activity of mRNA. So reduced penetration of the antibiotic through the membrane, increased efflux of the drug, hypersensitivity reaction, coagulation absorbability, and pseudolithiasis. So all these are the mechanism of resistance towards the cephalosporins. So till now we have majority of resistant first and second generation drug, third and fourth generation drug, still resistance level is very less. They are effective drugs. That's why now most of the physicians prescribe the third generation drugs, that is cefixime and ceftriaxone. Now we have this increased reflex, hypersensitivity, all these things. Adverse effects here are hypersensitivity, coagulation of probability, and pseudolithiasis. So coming to the next group of drugs, that is the carbapenems. So carbapenems are the beta lactamases that contain fused beta lactam ring and a 5-member system. So it differs from penicillin in being that it is unsaturated, that is double bond between C2 and C3 and containing the carbon atom instead of a sulfur atom. So the next drug here in this group is imipenem, that is N for imidoyl clindamycin. So that is the most stable derivative of clindamycin. So what are these carbapenems? So we should remember that when only when the other drugs are not effective, then only we think about this carbapenems or the imipenems, because these are the reserve group of drugs. And if there is resistance to these group of drugs, there will be very difficult situations where we will not be having any other antibiotics to work on with. So that's why these drugs are not commonly used and should not be commonly used. So the drug here is meropenem. It's a second generation carbapenem. So meropenem is not hydrolyzed by DHPs, a dihydropyridine, and is resistant to most of the beta lactamases, including the few carbapenemases that hydrolyze the diethylamine. So these carbapenems have lesser incidence of nephrotoxicity compared to imipenem. So this more meropenem has been correlated with greater stability to DHP. So monobactams have monocyclic beta lactam ring and are resistant to beta lactamases. So monobactams have monocyclic beta lactam ring and are resistant to beta lactamases. Aestrionum is isolated from the Chromobacterium violaceum. Aestrionum is isolated from Chromobacterium. So aestrionum is first clinically used to monobacter. So the antimicrobial activity of aestrionum differs from those of beta-lactam antibiotics and most closely resembles that of aminoglycosides. And that is more of gram-negative action that is important for the extended spectrum so that we can combine with other penicillins, other cephalosporins so that we can get an extended activity. I would like to call upon students to discuss about this first generation, second generation cephalosporins. Okay, we'll start with the last number in the class. This I assume roll number 73 is the last number in the class. Okay, roll number 73 is there.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Can you start with the classification?
Yes, sir. Cephalosporin. First generation, it consists of cephaloxin, cefadroxil, cefazolin. Second generation, it consists of cefuroxim, cefalacro, cefatoxin.
Thank you. Okay, 72.
Yes, sir.
Yes, can you repeat? First generation, second generation.
First generation, cefazolin.
Yeah. You can see you can see from the screen. Yes.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Cefadroxil. Yes. And second generation,
cefuroxime. Yes.
Cefoxitin, cefuroxime. Okay.
So this cefalexin and cefadroxil most commonly given in pediatric patients for upper respiratory tract infection. Cefuroxime is given in ENT for otitis media, otitis externa, severe pneumonia. All these cases we use this cefuroxime axetil, which is available both in oral and parenteral forms. Yes. First generation is roll number 71 is there. Okay, roll number 71 is not there. 70 is there. 69, 68, 67.
Yes, sir.
Yes. 67. Can you tell me which against which bacteria first generation is effective?
Sir, against streptococcus and
cephalococcus. It is active against gram-positive. Gram-positive organisms. Yes. Second generation, it is?
Gram-negative, sir.
Gram-negatives. And slight activity against gram-positive.
Gram-positive.
Okay? Yes. Okay. Roll number 66?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Third generation cephalosporins is active against?
Sir.
It is active against both gram positive and gram negative.
Gram negative.
Okay.
And has anti pseudomonal activity.
Okay. Yes. Roll number 65 is there? Yes. So among the third generation cephalosporins, among the three drugs, ceftriaxone, ceftriaxone, ceftazidime, WHO has chosen ceftriaxone as a drug of choice for typhoid infection. Okay. So for ceftriaxone injection is given for typhoid injection.
Yes, sir.
So which route this ceftriaxone is given? Ceftriaxone is given by parenteral. It is not available orally. Okay. Ceftriaxone is given by parenteral route.
Parenteral.
That means intravenous route. We are giving this ceftriaxone, which is given, which is now the present line of treatment for typhoid infections. Okay. WHO recommended parenteral dosage for this typhoid. Yes. Coming to the fourth generation and fifth generation, we told that they are the reserve group of drugs. But other important point here is they are active against both gram positive and gram negative, and also has activity against the pseudomonas. So roll number 60 is there with us. 60. Okay. 58, 57, 56, 55, 54, 53.
Yes, sir.
53 is present?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, can you tell me the three penicillin binding proteins on which the cephalosporins and the penicillins act? So cephalosporins and the penicillin act on three penicillin binding proteins. What are the penicillin binding proteins I told? Transpeptidase, carboxypeptidase, and endopeptidase. Can you repeat it?
Transpeptidase, carboxypeptidase,
and endopeptidase. Okay, thank you. Roll number 52 is there. Roll number 51. 50.
Yes, sir.
What's your roll number?
50, sir.
Okay, can you tell the three penicillin binding proteins on which the cephalosporins act?
Transpeptidase.
Yes.
Carboxypeptidase.
Yes. Endopeptidase.
Endopeptidase.
Okay, these are the three penicillin binding proteins which are helpful in the cross-linking of the peptidoglycan chain. Okay, these are the on which the penicillin binds. So peptidoglycan chain is cross-linked by the help of these three enzymes, and our penicillins or the cephalosporins, they go and block this enzymes. These enzymes are also called as PBPs or penicillin binding proteins.
Okay, sir.
Yes, roll number 49 is there. So roll number 58 and 68 has got time now. At the end of the session, they have got the time now to enter the class. So don't enter the class at the nth moment. So I'm taking attendance, please wait.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you show us the slide which showed us the drugs which were active against pseudomonal activities?
Yeah. I'll come to that. So you will get a YouTube link for this. Okay. Don't worry.
Okay.
So the class recordings will be put on the YouTube.
And okay, sir.
Yeah, you will get a slide share the details also.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So all those students who are not responding in the class will not get attendance. Yes, roll number 47 is there.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Can you read out the anti-pseudomonal activity cephalosporins?
Cefoperazone, ceftazidim, yes. Cefperom, cefepim, cefoxopran, ceftarolin, and ceftobipiron.
So it is so difficult to spell them even when I have repeated. Two times and it is repetition for you, still it is difficult to spell them. After 2 days, you just remember CEP. In the exams, you just know that it is starting with C, that's all. Okay, so that's why it is very difficult chapter, you need to remember it. Okay, it is cefaparazone, ceftazidine, cefpirome, cefepime, cefazopran, ceftaroline and ceftobiprole. Ceftaroline, ceftobiprole are fifth generation. Cefpirome is fourth generation. Cefaparazone is the second. Ceftazidine, third. Okay, cefepime is again third generation. So we need to remember these the drugs. Yes, roll number 45 is there. Okay. Roll number 44, 43.
Yes, sir.
What's your number?
43.
Yes. Can you tell me what are the drugs which are used against Pseudomonas? Okay, it is there on the screen. Can you read it?
Sir.
Cefaparazone.
Yes.
Ceftazidime. Cefepirome. Cefepime, cefazopran, ceftaroline, ceftobiprole.
You have done it. Okay. I'll be sharing the YouTube link with your Deepak sir. You can review the class again. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.